There are so many people in life, they forget to dream because they're afraid of going out of their comfort zone.
13 years ago, two enterprising pilots shared a dream to achieve the impossible. Their goal? To build the first solar-powered plane to fly around the world, ushering in an aviation future free of fossil fuels and pollution.
Our goal is simply to demonstrate that it's feasible.
Tango X-ray?
Their plan was ambitious, to cross the globe in 17 legs over the course of a year, logging 25,000 miles. Taking turns in the cockpit, co-pilots Bertrand Piccard and André Borschberg knew that they would face technical and operational challenges.
We have to go back.
While battling weather and the elements.
It has been really a difficult moment.
In an unprecedented bid for adventure and glory.
When I was a child, all the people I knew were explorers, adventurers, and astronauts.
You know, when I was a boy, I read a lot of books about the pilots who opened the lines, basically discovered the world through airplanes.
He is determined to succeed this time. He has spent...
My grandfather was the first man in the stratosphere, inventing the pressurized capsule. And then my father made the deepest dive ever, touching the bottom of the Mariana Trench, the deepest spot on Earth, and showing that the deepest trenches in the oceans had to be protected.
But I was fascinated by the people who tried something new, something different.
I thought exploration was the only way to live. I flew nonstop around the world in a balloon. We burned almost 4 tons of propane gas. It was pollution. And I was thinking, how can I do it with no fuel? And this is how the dream of Solar Impulse started. Fly in a solar-powered airplane that produces its own electricity with the sun, store the electricity in batteries, so you can fly through the night, fly to the next sunrise forever.
And when I met Bertrand 13 years ago, I immediately had the impression that my life was crossing something extremely important.
I found that André was the missing part of me, and I was the missing part of him. He's the engineer, entrepreneur, jet fighter pilot. I'm a medical doctor. I'm an explorer. So I asked him if he would agree to partner with me to do it. And he accepted immediately. Together, we could be the complete human being. It's a very difficult airplane to fly. Maybe the most difficult airplane in the world to fly because of its huge wingspan, very lightweight, and sensitivity to turbulence. So this you have to master completely.
So at the beginning, you just over-control it. It's a disaster. Using the simulator allowed us really to get the feeling about the personality of this airplane, to know how to handle it.
And I had the clearance from the tower.
And, you are clear to proceed.
And I could put full throttle, no noise from the engines, and the plane taking off. And I'm just looking to stay in the air as long as I can. No limit. When we travel, it takes 3 days to fly where other people would fly with a jet plane in 8 hours. But you know that you can stay there forever. And what is magical is to look at the sun, to look at the propellers on both sides, to see them turning without noise and without pollution, and to think, I'm in a film of science fiction. It cannot be true, but it is true. So as soon as André can put full power on the 4 electrical engines, the round the world will start. And I repeat, always, it's an attempt. The round the world with Solar Impulse 2 started in March 2015, André and I, we took turns in the cockpit. Prince Albert is next to me and he will give the official go. And then the adventure will start, my friend.
It's a great pleasure to wish you all the best for this fantastic crossing of the Pacific. So you are clear to proceed with the takeoff procedures.
As soon as I took off from Japan, one important equipment failed. And immediately the engineers told me that I had to return to Japan to fix it. But I looked at it completely differently. That was the first time that the weather was improving over the Pacific.
I would say we have to go back as we have the choice.
The engineers never understood that. They never understood why I was taking this risk. Some of them wanted to resign immediately, and I decided to continue.
There's only so much we can do to support you from here, from the ground. You will be on your own.
Let's go for it, and thank you for helping me, and thank you for helping us. We strongly believe it's not again, though.
It has been really a difficult moment. Do we go? We don't go. But the weather is good. The plane flies well. It's worth trying.
I did meditation. I couldn't sleep. And slowly at sunrise, I could throw this emotion overboard and I could go back to what I've been dreaming about to enjoy these days I was over the Pacific Ocean.
I don't know how many records we were setting in this flight, and it's the most difficult flight of the whole journey around the world that we succeeded.
Exploration is not only when you are successful and you raise the flag of victory. It's through all these moments where you have the impression to lose control.
The Solar Impulse 2 mission started in Abu Dhabi with many stopovers, across Asia first, over the Pacific, across the United States, over the Atlantic, across the Mediterranean Sea, to get back here in the Middle East.
I crossed the finish line over Abu Dhabi, and I had 1 hour and a half in the air waiting before landing. I could be in the full emotion of the success, but still in the full emotion of the adventure.
And at that moment, I thought, everything is possible. Everything is possible. Why don't we dream more? Why don't we try more?
And a few hours ago, I had to open the door of the cockpit. I had to land. And this flight around the world became memories.
What we did here was really pioneering work. And that's the industry slowly is understanding the potential of these technologies. In 10 years, you will use electric airplanes. Maybe not solar. This will take more time, but certainly electric.
If you have an impossible goal, the people who are going to support you are pioneers.